Dear students, now let us start with your remaining poem, the last remaining poem. And the name of the poem is Television by Roald Dahl. So something about the poet first. So Roald Dahl was a British poet. He was a novelist. He was a short story writer and he was a screenwriter as well. So one of his most prominent work is named Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. So the poem that we are going to do is an excerpt from this work only. And the poem is about the device, about the popular gadget television. So the poem is, the poem talks about the damage caused by television and also suggests an alternative to it. So for a better understanding of the poem, first of all, let us keep this in mind that the poem was written in 1980s. And that was the time when television was a very popular gadget and it occupied a place of pride in every home. So it was given a very prominent place in every living room, and the adults as well as the children, they were addicted to it. Just as these days we are addicted to our mobile phones, to our cell phones. In those days, children had a great liking for television, and the poem is basically addressed to the parents of the young children. So the poem is a warning to the parents that they must not let their children go near the television. So now, one thing more, and he also suggests an alternative to it. So like a good writer, like a good poet, he does not state the problem only. He also tries to give a solution. So here he says that the books may be a good alternative to television. So he does not merely say that television is bad, but he also tells us, if not television, then what? Then he suggests books. So if we give a thought to it, so when what is the difference between our watching of television and our reading of books? So have you given it a thought ever? So when we are reading books, we are transported to an altogether different world. So we try to imagine the characters, we try to imagine the setting, and we try to imagine the whole scenery from the words that the writer has written. And when we are watching television, then just try to think, what do we do? Everything is there in front of us, and we do not have the need to imagine anything. We are just just served everything right in front of us. We do not need to imagine any character. We do not need to imagine any setting, any scenery. So what does it do to us in the long run? So just give it a thought. So what does it do to us? It causes a lot of damage actually. So it kills our imagination because we do not need to imagine anything. Everything is served to us, and it kills our creativity, and it kills our reasoning power as well, because we just gobble up whatever is served to us. It is the same with our mobile addiction these days. So when we are using our mobiles, so we do not give it a thought, and we just believe in whatever the internet is telling us. So now let me start with the poem. It's a very beautiful poem. So I'll read it out and then I'll explain it. So the most important thing we have learned so far as children are concerned is never, never, never let them near your television set, or better still, just don't install the idiotic thing at all. So the writer starts the poem in a very simple manner. So he says that the most important thing that we have learned is that we should never let our young children near the television set at all. And what is better is that we should not install the idiotic thing in our homes at all. So you must have heard it before also that the television is referred to as the idiot box many times, because you do not need to imagine anything. It just makes an idiot out of you. So this is the meaning of idiot box. So he warns the children. The poem is addressed to the parents of the young children. So he addresses the parents and he tells them that they should not install the television in their homes at all. In almost every house we have been, we have watched them gaping at the screen. So then he proceeds further and he says that we have watched the children gaping at the screen. So now what is the meaning of gaping? Gaping is looking at something with your mouths wide open. So the children are simply taking in whatever is being shown to them, and their mouths are wide open. They loll and slop and lounge about and stare until their eyes pop out. So first of all, what is the meaning of loll? So loll is to sit or to lie in a very relaxed manner. And what is the meaning of slop? Slop is to do something carelessly. For example, you are eating something and you spill things about. So whenever you are watching television and you are eating simultaneously, so you invariably spill food. And then he uses another word, lounge. So lounge is when you are just spending your time in a lazy way. You are just sitting about and you are just lying around. And let me read the sentence again. They loll and slop and lounge about and stare until their eyes pop out. So they go on sitting or lying in front of their the TV sets in a very lazy manner, in a very careless manner, in a very relaxed manner, and they eat in front of the television and they just keep on staring at the screen until their eyes pop out. So staring is when you are looking fixedly at something. And then he uses parenthesis brackets and he says, last week in someone's place we saw a dozen eyeballs on the floor. So now this is he says that when he visited the place of somebody, he saw that the eyeballs were lying about on the floor. So this now we all know that this is something impossible. How can this happen? How can the eyeballs lie about on the floor? So we must understand it like this, that he is basically using exaggeration and humor to drive his point home. So he's basically saying that the children were looking so fixedly at the television that their eyeballs popped out. So it is a poetic device. He is using exaggeration and he is using humor to make the reader realize the gravity of the situation. So then they sit and stare and stare and sit until they are hypnotized by it, until they are absolutely drunk with all that shocking, ghastly junk. So they sit and stare. Stare, as we have discussed earlier, it is to keep on looking at something fixedly. So they just go on sitting and they just go on staring and staring and until they are hypnotized by it. Hypnotized, what is the meaning of hypnotized? When you are unable to use your brain. Your brain stops functioning and you are under somebody's sway. So you are unable to think independently. So this is being hypnotized. So the children are hypnotized because all the day, all the time they are watching television and they are unable to think on their own until they are absolutely drunk with all that shocking, ghastly junk. So they go on watching television until they are absolutely drunk. So as you all know, a drunk is again unable to think independently. He is unable to think on his own. So until they are absolutely drunk with all that shocking, ghastly junk. So again, junk is something useless. So television serves us with junk. And the children go on lapping up that junk